I think I also fixed remember the feedback we were getting? I think I fixed that. Not only did I fix the feedback, but I fixed the latency issue that I had when I was recording. So this setup should be ideal to get this thing rocking. So this is a master class on drill, and I'm going to show you how to drill it up. Yes. So hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. If you don't know me, I'm Gabe from BusyWorksBeats.com. We've trained over 800,000 producers around the world. Some have gone to work with Drake, Kanye West, Post Malone, Young Thug, Ariana Grande, Ray Shremmerd, French Montana, YG. I'm missing a whole bunch of people, but a lot of cool people. So we are going to get into drill today. Drill is, it's simple. I don't want you to overcomplicate drill. The cool part about drill is that you can combine it with almost any genre. And I'll show you how to do that in this master class as well. So Nafi Beats is here. Forgive me for not having the feedback yesterday. I had to do a last minute audible. Jimenez is here. We got Chris Chin here. What's up? Chic Ron TV, 1000 grams beats. All right, we got Agile Pupedi. We got Tyrone. Welcome back, Maestro. Also, I want you guys to go to NicoleNix.com to get vocal tags because this genre of music requires a vocal tag. I'm gonna play her tags off her site.
Okay, Chevy, I
Why
see
is it
you.
not giving me audio? I did that yesterday. Oh, maybe I can't hear it. Maybe that's why. I don't know if, tell me if you guys can hear these
You.
tags.
Okay, Chevy, I see
Yeah,
you.
thanks.
The high class rollers. 97031 in the booth. Oh, Tommy Digital, you called for
Prezi Moyer,
this.
shout out to you. Okay, I just can't hear the system
Damn,
audio.
Prezi.
Well, my new setup is better, so there should be less feedback loops, but if I do get a feedback loop some type of way, just let me know in the chat and I'll try to get to it because I can't hear the computer audio. So I fixed the latency issue and I fixed the feedback loop, I think. So shout out to my mentor and now business partner, Chris Moyer, also helping me behind the scenes with a lot of stuff. Today we're gonna try and show these folks the good secrets of drill beats because in the new Discord, which I need to link in the chat actually, the new Discord, you guys are live streaming in front of the audience. Let me make sure this actually goes somewhere because sometimes these Discord links don't take people anywhere. It might be expired, but no, it's not. Okay, so basically, if you join us in the Discord, you can live stream your screen with everybody else. And I noticed a lot of the people in there were making drill beats. So that's why I want to show you how to make drill beats if you want to be a live streamer in our new Discord and share your secrets with other producers and get a following that way. All right, 808 slides. Yeah, we'll get into everything. I'll make it super simple too. Drill really isn't that complicated. You just need to know how they time their hi-hats and the snare. Yeah, so the chat kind of is moving fast. I'm not used to reading white text on black, but shout out to you guys. So yes, Nicole Nix, let me plug her website real quick before we get it to rock and click here for vocal tags. Because with drill beats, you need a tag. That's kind of like the thing that separates your sound from everybody else. Because drill sounds the same for the most part. It just has the same elements, the same rhythm. What makes it different is the storyline behind it. So let's start off with the hi-hats. Let me know if the sounds are too loud. We're gonna right click, let's go to open a new channel. And the hi-hat is the most simple one. Let's hit Control L, send it to the mixer. And drill, you wanna start around 144. Now the cool part about drill is we can make drill in B, we could do rage drill, we could do, what else is there? Rage drill, drill in B. You could do regular drill, New York drill, grimy drill, you name it. So I think we're gonna start off with maybe like typical drill, and then we'll get into the other genres. I'll show you guys how to do it. Okay, so the key is go to 144 BPM, turn your metronome on, which is this little icon right here. And then the hi-hats just go tut 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 tut. We could do UK drill, it's a little bit different though. Tut 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 tut. Okay, so it's not triplets. I'm assuming the person who tried to do it thought they were doing triplets, but they weren't doing triplets. So it's tut 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 tut. Let's go to pattern mode. Also, I don't know if my mic's too loud, but what's up, Ninaf? He was in there streaming. Also, you want short, tight sounds. So I have the sounds. I'm gonna give you guys the project files for free. All you gotta do is just join our Discord. Let me put that in the link because I'm gonna forget. Hold on one sec. Let me fix the link. Click here to join us in Discord and get your project files for free. So I'm gonna compile all the projects, and then I'll put it in our Discord exclusively for you guys to download. Okay, so that you'll have the sounds and everything. Okay, so the first thing is you want short sounds. This sound is too long. Even though it's short sound, it eats up too much of the middle. So we need to fade it out. And I can't tell which part is the mic feeding back, so I'm gonna mute up my headphones for a sec. Okay, so once you have that rhythm, you can create variations of that rhythm, but that's the core rhythm. Ta 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 ta. It's not triplets, it's quarter timing. Let's hit shift, pull that over. That's really the key to drill. But let's go to here, go to make unique. We're gonna go inside pattern two, and let's change up something about it. Maybe ta 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 ta, like just little stuff like that. So let's figure out ta 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 ta. So we just need to go to our graph editor and turn down the velocity. So this is where you get to play a little bit and create your own little bounce. Now I want it to go bra ta ta, not ta 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 ta. Okay, ta 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 ta. I want it to go bra ta ta. So let's right click, go to piano roll, and we're gonna grab that note just before. So it goes bra, it goes into the note. We're gonna hit Alt A, change your time multiplier to anything you want, and change your range to 1. Hit accept. Then we're gonna right click the velocity and fade it up. So it goes. Okay. Also, you can mess with the velocity per note. I haven't tried that, but you could try up down velocity. That's another kind of technique. So up down up, up down up, and then up down up, up down up. Creates like a push-pull effect, almost like a swingy effect. It's a little too smooth for me, but I'll use it for now, but I might change that up later. Okay, let's go to song mode. So notice everything's not the same velocity. That's what I'm getting at. Except on pattern one. See how more, I'll turn my mic off for a second. I just want you to feel the movement of the second hi-hats as opposed to the first one. In my opinion, the second run of hi-hats was a lot more animated. So that's why I'm showing you these little tiny things that create the sound you're looking for. Let's clone that out. Hit Control B to clone it out. And now we're gonna add our snare. So hi-hats and snares are like the sound of the genre. So let's go to pattern 3. Let's find a snare. So the snare needs to be a rim snare. And I'm trying to remember where I put the rim snare. I put stuff all over the place. Let's go to Friends Sounds and Drill. Okay, so here's the drill sound. Let's open this up. And then we're gonna go to trim, and you can fade it, but we don't need to fade the sound. We just want it to be a nice short, like the wood side of the snare. Okay, so let's just do, we're gonna put the snare, now there's so much to explain. I go over this in Beat Magic, which is at busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic. We go over drill, we go over the main genres of hip hop, click here. Or how to make beats. It's a whole course on how to make beats. You guys asked for a completely dedicated course on how to make beats, and it's called Beat Magic. So just go to busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic. So in Beat Magic, I go over the different styles of drill. You have New York drill, Chicago drill, you have UK drill, you have, I know I'm missing some. You have all the fusion genres. So basically, in America, we put our snares on the 3 and the 7 count. But what we take from the UK is putting the snare instead of the 7. In other words, when I play the metronome, just count. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's how we count. So usually we put our snares on the 3 and the 7. Now in New York, they're cool with this. But in the majority of like what we consider drill, like Pop Smoke, he puts his snare on the 8. Okay, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so it's up to you where you put it, but I'm gonna put the snare on the 8. So that's the main snare. Now you can bounce it around like we did with the hi-hat. So let's make the second one unique. So it's a whole new pattern. And let's clone these out, hit Control B. Let's go to pattern 4. And let's add the same kind of bounce that we did with the hi-hats. So using the velocity. So I wanna go boom, 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 ta, 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 ta. So it's boom, 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 ta, 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 ta. Let's just add that in. Now I don't want the snares to double up because it sounds better with the hi-hat going. Okay, but let's go to the graph editor and just turn the velocity down. So it just sounds like a little percussion as opposed to a hard snare. Okay, so you can have a whole bunch of different bounces using that technique to keep that velocity. Let's turn down the hi-hat. It's a little jarring to the ear. So again, the whole trick to the UK sound is, to the drill sound is those hi-hats and the snare. So all you really need right now is just a bass, an 808 slide, and then you need the heavy kick. So the heavy kick we put in the Drake folder. Here it is. You just need a really full kick. Okay, the kick has to be super, just has to be full. There's no other word for it. Okay, so we're just gonna add it on the downbeat. Now most people, they slam their kicks because they have bad kick samples. You don't wanna necessarily slam this into the red. Shout out to Lil Durk. Because we wanna leave room for the 808. But the key is to let the kick hit and then let it fade. Give room for the 808. So it's kick, 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 kick. And here's where we take from the Chicago rhythm. So Chicago is all about one, two, 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 boom, 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 boom. Okay, it's about those kicks. Young Chop started this and the whole Chicago drill movement. So we're gonna add the kicks on the downbeat, and that's what's gonna give it a hardness, so to speak. One, two, two, two. Okay, and then it's back to the beginning. So you can switch it up how you like it. But we took that technique from Young Chop. So shout out to Young Chop and the Chicago drill producers out there. Now let's get to these 808s. So it's a very drum first kind of genre, I'm starting to realize. Now you can add hi-hat rolls over top this stuff. This is just the core rhythm. I did that really slow. So right now I wanna go. So I'm gonna go to a new pattern. And here I'm just gonna add the embellishing, the garnish, so to speak, over top. So I'm gonna add ta-ta-ta-ta. It's a little bouncy stuff. You don't have to do this. This is an optional step. Let's go inside our piano roll, right click, go to piano roll. And I'm gonna choose a different note. So instead of playing the sample at middle C, which is how the sample should be played, I'm gonna play it on a different note. Ta-ta-ta. So I kinda like that pause. Ta-ta-ta. That's like a UK style. Leaving these gaps, okay? Now, a more American style would be to fill it up. Ta 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 ta. One, two, three, four. So let's switch it up. Let's do both. Let's leave the gap this time. Let's cut out that note. That was almost like a Jay-Z bounce. Also, I think Timbaland may have started this, or whoever produced for Jay-Z back in the day with that. It's the Jigga Man. Like whoever created that bounce, I kind of hear it in the drill bounce. Cause they used to rap like, I'm the big pimp, me L-A-T, we got the A-L-A-B. Like that's how Jay-Z used to rap. So I think we're really just coming full circle to Jay-Z's flow. Jay-Z was a goat way ahead of his time. So let's create that kind of party sound. So I'm gonna fix the end hi-hats. So if it gets in the way, I'll fix those later. So now we have a lighthearted kind of bounce. Now I'm not gonna add the 808 just yet. Let's go to guitars. Let's add an acoustic guitar. So we're gonna use, what's it called? Ample Guitar M. And here's where I'm gonna insert the vocal tag. So again, shout out to NicoleNix.com, the wonderful, magnificent, NicoleNix.com. Click here for vocal tags. So here's where I got my tags. She did my tags for me. And where is it at? Let's go here. So this, you have to pick a tag that matches. So
busy.
This one fits the vibe. My bad, y'all. It's because I have my stuff going out to the audio. I have my stuff going out to an analog chain, so sometimes the latency when FL tries to pull causes a weird error. My bad. Let's do that one more time. You guys can hear me? Audio should be good. Just let me know. Check, check, check. Audio should be good. My bad on that. So anyway, go to NicoleNix.com. Let me make sure I didn't skip anything. Oh, you know what it was? I know what it was. It was ample guitar that did that. That was ample guitar loading up. It glitched on me. So let's load up the vocal tag first. Drag this in. And let's turn this down.
Busy.
Let's load up. That's why I don't like to use ample sound guitars much, because it adds, it just has a weird like interface buffer issue. So what I'm going to do is load it up one more time. But I would play it by hand. I need to practice more. So one thing I will do on this guitar, again, this is not free, I had to buy this one. I'm going to turn off the reverb. We're going to add our own reverb. But the cool part about this plugin is it revoices properly to a guitar's voicing. So if I play a major 7 chord, it's going to play it like an actual guitarist would play it, as opposed to a piano player, because the voicing is different. So I'm just going to kind of mess around and try to see if we can get like a Jigga Man vibe on this one.
Busy.
Any drum kits, you can get the project files for free. I'm going to give you these project files, so you're going to get them for free. All you got to do is just join our Discord. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you guys the link to the Discord, but I'm going to put the Discord link first. Shout out to everybody who's here. I appreciate you hopping in. Give me one sec. I want to give you guys the link to our new Discord, because this is where we're actually sharing a lot of information, a lot of stuff. So I need you guys to hop in with us early. Is that right? Yeah, click here. So I'm gonna pin the comment. If you want to join in real quick, replace pin comment. There we go. All right. So here's NicoleNix.com.
Okay, Chevy, I see you. The high class rollers. 97031 in the booth. Oh, Tommy Digital, you called for this.
I'm assuming you can hear these tags, because I can't.
Damn, Prezi.
All right. Good. Now back to business here. We got
busy.
Let's come up with some Jay-Z style guitar. Kind of how Pop Smoke introduced it to us just before he passed. RIP. Let's do like. Let's do. So let's 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is a minor. Sounds like a major chord. Let's do. So. One, two, three. So we're just following that, the hi-hats. So I'm going to play this one note by itself because I just like it. Dun, 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 dun. One, two.
Busy.
Oh, I should be. Dun, dun, dun. Yeah, that's what we'll do. One, two.
Busy.
Hit the wrong note, but it's all good. Wait. There we go.
Busy.
Okay, let's layer this up. Drop a drill, rapper, I'm a drill. So we need another guitar. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use a different guitar. So you guys are looking for cheaper plugins. Maybe you don't have the money for ample guitar. What is it called? Ample sound guitar, whatever the company's called. Ample Guitar M, whatever the company's name is. You can get Expand 2. Let's load up some guitars from here. And let's go to guitars and pull up some options here. So here's where we're going to add the top line stuff. give it a different texture too, so it feels different.
Busy.
So now I'm thinking of another melody instead of dum dum dum. Maybe we can do chugga 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 chugga. So the key is like when one thing's doing one thing, the other thing's doing something as the other thing's not doing the other thing. In other words, when one instrument is playing, the other instrument is not playing, and when they don't play, the other one plays. Chugga chugga. Wait.
Busy.
Let's go. We got a Timbaland drill beat. Let's go. Hold up. Okay, let's just record this. Then I'll think about chords. I don't know if this is a chord type of song. One, two.
Busy.
I messed up the ending, but these are dotted notes, so it's a little harder to play it. So it's not like triplets, I don't think. Actually, let me figure out what kind of note is it.
Busy.
This is kind of hard to describe. Wait, one, two, three, four, one, two, three. I guess it's just two notes. It's hard to hear though.
Busy.
Yeah, it's just two notes, but it's the velocity in which I played it. So the harp. Let me just see something.
Busy.
I'm gonna add some chorus to it. Only thing is, if I quantize, it cuts off some of the lengths, so I gotta manually go through.
Busy.
I like that bounce. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I know I'm moving a little bit quicker here, but all these long notes that are just before the one note, we're gonna hit control and shift. And then we're going to highlight all the beginning notes by left clicking. That allows you to select one note at a time and then select multiple notes, control shift. So I'm going through, it's a lot of tedious work after you quantize, but basically I'm going to grab that first note, hit alt, and then left click and make it shorter.
Busy.
Then we'll add the background stuff. So here's another shortcut. Let's say you want it to sound like a Spanish guitar, like where they go. You could highlight the note, hit Alt A, change your time multiplier.
Busy.
And this treats it like a glitch plugin. Bring, bring. Okay, so you can mess with that. If you want to change up your melodies a little bit, you could do that. Okay, so we have the general sound. I'm going to mix it to sound more chorusy in a second. But now I have to decide, do I want to add something really musical behind it, or do I want to just add something dark? So this is the point where we have to decide, like, what kind of vibe is it going for? So I think we need something musical. So let's do like a sad musical sound. Let's go to expand to, actually, we don't even need that. Let's go to FL keys. Free plugin. I'm gonna put the velocity on max to try out different chords here. Let's hit Control L. Figure out what key we're in first.
Busy.
Use my sustain pedal here. So we need. Let's figure out the root note.
Busy.
Trying to decide what kind of vibe. Here's where, again, you get to determine the emotional direction. Are we gonna go super dark? We're gonna go super happy? We're gonna go chorus, orchestral?
Busy. Busy. Busy.
Okay, I had to make those line up.
Busy.
So I think we're gonna go cinematic. Let's see what Expand 2 has. I can show you how to edit. We didn't format yet. Let's go to strings. Okay, so here's where you can find all the orchestral stuff to go behind it. So I think this is how we're gonna add the emotion, because with strings you don't need to you don't necessarily need to play big chords like a ninth chord, unless you're doing like a Pharrell track. So that's why people choose strings, is because you can get away with less complicated voicing, like a D minor. But we're in a weird key, so we're in. So the chords are a little bit different. So I'm just trying to find that root note.
Busy.
Let me draw it out, because that way you guys can see. So I'm stacking up the music because I want it to build up into something else and not sound like a typical, like everybody else. So here's like a fusion. I guess we got in a fusion. So right now I'm gonna play G minor. That's a very dark chord. So if you wanted to go into dark mode, G minor. So instead of G, it's G, B flat, D. Okay, and then we're gonna add that in. Now we're gonna start there, but I'm gonna change up the chords. Give me a second, let's loop this. That's why I said the guitar makes me want to dance, but then if you go dark, then you gotta tell that dark narrative. Let's see what we're gonna do. Let's add another low note. Let me take off the dinner for a second. So I'm gonna, I know what I want. So I want a legato, like pitchfall. Now this library is not cheap at all, so I'm loading up the real thing so you can see what I have in my brain. Because this is, these are the type of instruments the top producers use, they just don't tell you about it. So this one's called Orchestral Tools Metropolis Arc 1. This is really for film scoring, but you could use it for drill beats. Now a lot of people, they tell you to get these really cheap libraries like Expand 2 with the strings, even though the strings are good. I don't want to call it cheap like that. I mean, cheap is in price. Nexus has some cheaper. What's up, Jay Cactus? This is his lane. I just saw in the Discord people were, they kept live streaming drill. So I'm like, do you guys like drill that much? I guess they do. Jay Cactus is the actual person to go to for all things drill. Do you use this, since he's here? Do you use Metropolis Arc? Because I want to go da 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 down. Wait, da 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 da. That one could be tighter, but let's see what else we have. We have other articulations here. Let's try a unit. Got some sound effects. Yeah, this is for movies and stuff. I'm trying to find the, there's one in Contact called Session Strings Pro. That's what it's called, in Contact. And they have this thing where you can have the pitch fall for the string. So it's that cardio, it's the cardiac sound, the flat line. Excuse me, sound. So I'm trying to find that articulation real quick. This is the thing about real libraries. They have so many articulations that you don't get from, but I can't find it. So I'll just use this one. Not the one I was looking for. Hear how it pitch bends? So that gives you a different, tighter sound. Kind of like mono when you're doing synth stuff, but with a little portamento. So let me add that in. Wait. Now I forgot the note. Wait. There we go. That is, feels like Britney Spears, Toxic. Love that you die. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Then I'm gonna find some sound effects. Okay, so now we need to layer it in. So bum. Now, I wish there was a better articulation. Maybe there is. Let me try one more thing. What's the other library? I have a library called 8DO. Yeah, let me see. Also, Action Strikes. I'm going to put you guys on the Action Strikes as well. But if you go to 8DO, 8DIO, there's a patch called Strings Legato. And this should give us what we're looking for. Let's see, hold up. That's sustain. This is called medium. Can't tell if I have the max velocity on or not. That sounds, maybe I do, I can't tell. Alright, let's try strong. Let's just see what these sound like. So we boom, 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 boom. You don't have to do boom, boom, boom like Kanye. Boom, 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 boom. Y'all want to say what's up to Nicole Nix real quick? But let me turn on the beat. Everybody in the chat, if you love me, tell Nicole Nix that you love her with a little heart emoji. You ready? Here's how you spell Nicole Nix, by the way, for those who don't know. Real quick, I need y'all to help her brother out. Let her know how much love you got for her, ready? As I play the beat, I gotta turn off my mic though. I know my neighbor's super mad at me for cranking my speakers like that. Shout out to my baby girl, Nicole Nix. Did I have her tags in the beginning of this track? But let me send her a picture real quick. Thank you, y'all. Appreciate y'all. So let's take out these. So let's add that root note. He said F the neighbors. So again, we're trying to add our own spin to drill. We don't want to do the typical, you know, that kind of vocal run. I mean, it's cool to use loops and all that, do your own thing, but this is my style. I want to create like a Jay-Z bounce with a cinematic. I'm missing something here though. Also, I'm going to compress the guitar so it's not so boomy. Boom, boom, boom. But we need more like cinematic strings, so we need more strings like that sound like actual strings. So I'm going to show you guys a secret library. It's called 8DO Majestica. It's called Brass. And then load these up. This is the Batman. She says she's sending her love to y'all. And this is the Batman sound. So once you hear it, you'll know what I'm talking about. Wait, save? No. So you hear this, and you used to hear this in almost every EDM track. So we're gonna add that in. Let's add a little darkness. Now you can do the long ones. You don't have to do the short ones. Let's do long real quick. I don't know if they have that in long. I guess they do. We're about to get to the 808s. That's the other part to the sound. But I just want to do the music first before we get to the bass. Because most people, when they do the bass, they don't add enough music. Boom. So all we're doing is just adding the root note and just dragging it out. Two octaves of the root note, which is G. Remember, we played the G minor chord. So let's add that in. It might be too long. That's a little too long. I want to go lower. Boom. Wait. Oh, that was dope. I did that by accident. It was like, so I did that by accident, but how'd I do that? I went low to high. So here's a little secret for you guys. You unlocked the secret by accident. This is my thank you because you said hello to Nicole Nix. I appreciate you. So this is my thank you to you. You ready for this secret that probably nobody knows about? Is, so when I went like this by accident, I'm gonna show you how to do that. Just give me 3 seconds. 3 seconds, there we go. So let's do 3 seconds of that. And let's see. So we're gonna go from G. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. So what you do is you grab the note and you slide it. And I want to end on G. So I'm gonna grab all these notes that are all the white notes or all the notes you would play on a keyboard, stack them up. Okay, and then grab this, hit Alt S, and then change your strength. And all you wanna do is just line it up so that the end note is right at the downbeat. Now, if it's too slow, you can always go back and move that starting note. You'll hear what it sounds like in a second. So it goes down in volume. I meant to go up in volume. So what I'm gonna do is to fix that is just right click and fade it the other way so that it creates the heavy articulation at the top. So all I'm gonna do to fix this, there's a couple notes that were heavy articulated. So here's, okay, so it goes, okay, you slide into it. You can also make these notes shorter. So you can hit Alt, left click, and make those shorter. And that way you get like a rolling brass. That's a little free sound effect. So I'm gonna turn that down. Let's compress this guitar because I know you guys don't want that thing booming. So IK Multimedia just sent me over, thanks to Alex. He sent me the T-Rex bundle from IK Multimedia. They have this plugin called the Comprexer, which I really like because it is a distressor, but it has mid-side mode and you can do a lot of stuff with it. So I'm just gonna use it at a typical 4-to-1 ratio. Give it a quick attack and a pretty long release. I just want the compressor to grab on the sound so it cuts out the body of the sound. So it just has a peak and then no body, but we hear the tone. I'm gonna push the input. I want it to be grabby. So it's a little more dynamic. Basically, we're just carving like a concave curvature into it. Okay, let's go back to the beginning because we've got lost in the music there.
Busy.
Now, when I show you the 808 slides, that's what's going to give it that edge. So it's just little accents. Then we can do a string melody, like a violin melody, if you guys want, like in reverse.
Busy.
So here's where we get to add the identity. Now, I think we should go synth and then reverse it. So let's go Omnisphere and let's do a synth. It says Omnisphere loads up. Let's go to, we need something bright.
Busy.
Let's go to Synth Poly. And there's so many synths in here to choose from. Let's type in like, let me think, maybe a Juno. Just any kind of, not any kind of synth. Yeah, put a 100, I guess up in my head. I'm tripping V-long, that's what I'm wearing. Jane Foster, you know, ain't older than that. I pulled out, I'm back in there. Okay, so we need something bright. So I'm just gonna mess around the key real quick, and then we're gonna reverse the melody, and I'll show you how to reverse the melody without like getting confused when you print it to audio. So it sounds bare right now because we don't have the vocal, we don't have the 808, and we don't have the melody. Oh, that was it. Wait.
Busy.
That was kind of dope. So it's just simple. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3.
Busy.
Thank you. let's add that in. Very basic melody, but we don't need it to be super exotic. Let's hit Alt Q. Now here's what we're gonna do. I like it forward, but if you wanted to reverse it, you would go to your tools, go to flip, and then flip it horizontally. Hit accept.
Busy.
See how it messes up the time? So I don't know how this works in reverse, because I played everything quantized. Here's what I'll do first. Let's quantize it first. Alt Q, then hit reverse, because I don't know how it just changes all the times like that. Let's flip horizontal.
Busy.
See how it's like dum 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 dum. That's not how I played it though. So I don't know why it does that. I'm not sure how FL has that programmed. Let's see if we preserve time start times. Hit accept.
Busy.
So here's what we're gonna do. Let's right click. Let me save the project, because you never know what can happen from here. So right click, consolidate this track from track start, hit accept. All right, my bad. So I knew that was gonna happen. Sometimes when I try to send it out to audio, it freaks out because I have so many outputs that happens. Let's try this one more time. So again, I reversed the MIDI.
Busy.
Okay, right click, consolidate this track from track start. Let's pray. Actually, let me mute my mic. That could be messing with this. Success, it worked. Okay, so now that you have it printed, now you can re-reverse the MIDI. So let's go to channel settings and hit reverse again. So now it's forward, but it sounds backwards.
Busy.
And here's where you get that pop smoke type sound. So one thing we have to fix though is, since it's in reverse, some of the transients don't line up. So let's go to snap the grid, let's go to 1/4 beat, and you can kind of visually see where like the transients don't line up. So I'm going to grab the slip tool and then hit alt, left click, and actually we might have to do alt. Let's grab the pencil tool, alt, left click, and drag it a little to the right. So I don't know if you guys can see because the screen might not be big enough, but now the beginning of that sound is perfectly lined up.
Busy.
Now also, this is like a caveat, but you want your melodies to be a little bit off the grid, like a tiny bit to the right, most of the time. Because your melodies don't always start right on the downbeat. Dun, 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 dun. They just don't start like that. Sometimes it's like, dun, 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 dun. You know, it's a little bit behind the beat. So I'll exaggerate it and then we'll pull it back.
Busy.
So I'm hitting Alt right. And now we have the identity for the track. Okay, so now we can go into that musical section. So that's our identity for the melody, and we're gonna send this through a lot of reverb. So I'm hitting shift, left click, and drag it over, and that's gonna keep the same timing so that it doesn't sound like a super quantized.
Busy.
Now we need to give it reverb and all this stuff, so I'll move a little bit quicker with the reverb. And once we get into the mixing, that's where we're gonna get the identity for the song. But we needed that one thing to give it an identity, and I think that synth is the one. So let's go to Valhalla Vintage Verb, let's cut out the lows, and let's go back to our synth.
Busy.
Let me see, did I route it to the mixer? I didn't. So let's call this Melody, and let's hit Control L to send it to the mixer. Then we're gonna left click and send it to the reverb.
Busy. Busy.
Now it sounds more atmospheric and big. I learned this from Wavy Wayne, shout out to Wavy Wayne. He says, pull down the volume of your mono if your reverb is like too overkill. So in short, we're gonna use the, Isotope Dynamics, which is a compressor. Go to all mode, switch it to mid-side mode, go to mid. I know I'm moving quickly, but this is stuff that we go over in our premium section. And we actually have a free course for drills. So if you guys want to learn more, just go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. Click here for the free drill beat course. Drill beat course. Yeah, that sounds more proper. Okay, so you can link right to the website and get free training right there. So I know I'm moving a little bit quicker here, but I'm not trying to make this about mixing. But anyway, you pull down your mono and the reverb, and that will tame some of the stuff that's in the way of your stuff. And then we could do 808s last. Also, you can experiment with halftime. So if you guys are, if you like that kind of slowed down effect, you can go to half gross beat, go to presets, momentary, go to half speed, and then pull down your time. Or you can do full half speed. But the thing is, it only plays two notes. So to kind of prevent that, you can go to channel settings and then go to mode, stretch mode, and then pull down your pitch one octave. So that's 1200 cents. Now you get that Pop Smoke type of vibe. The only thing about gross beat, or no, that's not gross beat, never mind. But if you, with gross beat, if you hit stop and play and click stuff, it'll offset. Just keep in mind. Thank you, Victorious. So now we can get to the 808 and then the drum mixing. So here's where we need to start giving ourselves headroom. So I'm going to pull down some of the volume so we can leave headroom. Kind of want to do rage. Y'all made me want to switch this to an electric guitar. Bum, bum, bum. That might be OD. You guys want to do rage drill? So I'm going to switch this to Ample Guitar SC, and then we're going to run this through a guitar rig amp, and I'll show you how to get that rager type sound. So I'm going to take it. I know I'm moving quickly here, but it's a lot to explain. So we're going to turn off the amp, turn off the effects like delay and reverb. And we are going to run this guitar directly through either guitar rig. I'm going to run it through, where's our, I think we still have it. It's called Diesel something. I don't know if I have the demo still or what. The demo ran out, darn it. Or we could do, that was the one though. It's called Diesel H or VH4. Anything Diesel I found gives you that sound. Darn, I ran all my demos off. Okay, so let's just do guitar rig then. But I have found that UA does have the best sound as far as like amps. But guitar rig's good too. Oh, you know what? There's Amplitube. I forgot. So this is from IK Multimedia. They have a plugin suite called, a guitar amp plugin called Amplitube. I used to love this plugin. And then I lost my download, but I found it again. Thank you, Alex from IK Multimedia. So let's see if they have like a Diesel emulation. They have so many amps. Holy crap. They even categorize them. So some are for bass and so many high gain. I don't even know where to start. So I'm going to go to presets and let's go to amplify. I'm going to click around. We're just going to click. Let's just click stuff. First, before you hit play, turn down your volume on your guitar. Busy. Because that will blow your ears off. It's an interesting sound. Now the guitar is a little tight. It's too on the beat. So what we're going to do, find your guitar, go to your settings, go to your wrench tool, and then go to time shift. So it will pull the notes a little to the right so they're not perfectly on the grid. See if we can go lower. I don't think we can though. Yeah, this is the lowest octave. So I know I'm doing a lot, but I'm trying to put you guys onto a lot of stuff. Let's just try a different preset. It's called Amplitube. You talking about this one? Amplitube. Like amplitude, but with a B. I'm gonna go through presets. Oh, they do have a Diesel. Let's go. Okay, it's called DZ Power. I guess they call it the V Handcraft 4. Okay, whatever. So here's the heavy metal one. It's a little reverby, so let me figure out how to turn off the reverb. So let's click around here. Has an LA-2A on it, has an EQ, and I'm gonna put, can you move this around? I'm gonna put the, I don't know what I just did. I'm gonna put the noise gate at the end. I think I just did that right. So with heavy guitar like that, it goes, it rings out a lot. So you have to use a noise gate to contain the body of the guitar. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm just cutting off the tail end of the reverb. Sounds a little reverby though. I don't know how to turn that off. Where is the reverb? Wow. You could do 3 amps. Holy crap. Okay. So they clearly have updated a lot of stuff since the last time I checked out Amplitude. I'm just trying to figure out how to get to the reverb section of this thing. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this one because if I can't see it, I can't see it. But another one you want to try out is a pitch shift. So this is called pitch shift. We're going to grab that in. And what you want to do is pull it down an octave. Let's see if we get, let's go down one octave or negative 12 semitones. See if we can do that. See how it's like, that's kind of, you have to mess with it. Oh, that's because I'm doing it after the amp, my bad. We need to do it before the amp. So now it just sounds super big. Okay, so I'm just showing you guys a little more advanced stuff just so you get an idea of how far you can take it. We're not going to spend a lot of time on that. Let's just get the headroom real quick. Push the kick a little bit. So I'm pushing the kick, and what you can do if you are crazy, you can send it through a Fruity Soft Clipper and then turn your threshold to the right and just keep cranking the gain into the kick. This is gonna make it really big, but you wanna watch your levels because again, we're not trying to clip the whole track. And again, we still need to leave room for the 808. So right now I'm just trying to get the levels right. I think the melody is moving a little too much, so let's compress it just a little bit so it doesn't move as much. So I'm going to use the T-Rex compressor just to keep it stable because it's, oh, that's the wrong one. They have a bus compressor. They have so many plugins. I'm excited all over again because as a producer, I need new stuff. Anyway, so here's the compressor, which models the distressor. And for the melody, we just need it to be more stable. Instead of wah, 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 it's taken away from the groove of the hi-hats. So we're gonna keep it stable. Okay, you can push the compressor so that it grips onto the sound. So give it like a fast attack. It sounds a little fast. I don't even know if it copied our values. Let me see if it did, but it still sounds fast to a degree. So I'm going to hit Alt Right to move it. It's a little bit better in the groove. But let's say you're okay. So let me just show you a trick. If your melody isn't like vibing with your groove, what you could do is slap a gross beat on it and override the groove of the sample, because a lot of you guys probably make drill beats from samples. So what you can do if the sample doesn't match your rhythm in the song, you could put a gross beat on top. Go to your time feature, and then you could carve out like a manual effect. So I'm just gonna do a single curve. Let me see what kind of rhythm I want. I don't know if I wanted to swell up like, or if I wanted to go down like. So let's just try both because we don't know which one will sound better. And this will override the bounce of the melody. And then it will fit into our rhythm, our song. And we still didn't get to 808s yet. I like this better. So let's increase the attack a little bit. You can even hear it catch some of the transients. We need the level. Let's find our strings. So everything sounds separate because they're not going through the same reverb. We can widen the guitar. So everything can't be wide. That's another principle. Okay, so now let's grab our 808. So it took us that long to add the 808 because I don't like to start with the bass because I find myself not being deeply expressive with the music if I start with the bass. It tends to lock me in. So let's go to Friends and let's find our 808. So you can also, I think we added this into the Discord, which is linked on the YouTube chat. I think we added 808s. Let me actually check. Do we add the 808s? Because if you go to our Discord link, we have a bunch of free downloads. If you just click on the left side in the Discord and go to like the download section, whatever it's called free downloads. And let me check in the Discord if we have the 808s in here. Let me see before I say what I have in here. But again, you will get these project files for free as I continue this live. Give me 1 second to check. So under free downloads, we have 100 free FL Studio project templates. You can get those for free. Just for joining the Discord. We have Metro Boomin's official drum kit and a project file. We have some guitar loops in here. We have some vintage drums, like the Weeknd style drums. We have the power pack. So I didn't add the 808 pack. That was for Jay Cactus's giveaway. That's what I was thinking of. But you're going to get these project files. So you're going to have everything you're going to need anyway. So let's grab an 808 and let's see which essential 808s. So we need an 808 that's long and tonal. So the Spins 808 gives us that type. Now just go for longer 808s. There's a lot of 808s out there. So again, our root note is G. So for this song, I'm gonna spread out the sound. So everything can't be eating up space. So here's where I'm gonna do like the nuanced work, which is to go to the wrench tool and turn up time shift for most stuff.
Busy.
Okay, so now let's go back to the 808. Okay, so we're just playing octaves and then we're playing that same tension point we did with the melody. So technically this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're playing the fifth, we're playing the sixth and then coming down to the fifth. So it's the root note, sixth, fifth, root note, and I'm playing octaves. So I'm just going from down to up. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Busy.
Six, fifth, boom. Then we'll do the octave next time around. Octave. I'll change the notes.
Busy.
Okay, so I'll change that guitar note.
Busy.
It's not matching, I don't think. Let's pull it up now. Gotta lower the noise gate. Give me a second to edit the sound. Alright, so we got that. And what else do I need to do with that guitar? I need to pull it back one little. Okay, So with the 808s, so here's where we're gonna have to use mixing. This is why I left it for last, because with the 808s, if you don't know how to mix the 808s, you're gonna have a kind of a difficult time. Clean your backup folders. I'm not familiar. Do I ever clean my backup folders? No, I probably should backup everything on my computer. Click here for vocal tags. So here's Nicole Nix's vocal tags.
Okay, Chevy, I see you.
Add one to this track.
The High Class Rollers. 97031 in the booth.
And then I'll show you how to do slides, different slides.
Oh, Tommy Digital, you called for this. Damn, Prezi.
All right, so you can go to Nicole Nix for your vocal tags. And I have one in this track right now. Let's go back to the beginning.
Busy.
Okay, so for 808 slides, I'm not going to do the typical slides. We're going to do slides that are very different. But before we get to the slides, I want to see how many people are in here. That's what I forgot to do. So let's see how many good folks are up in here before I share all the 808 secrets. We have 153. I need you guys to smash the like button because I'm dropping all the game for you for free. All the secrets, all the production, trade secrets. So I need you guys at least to pay a brother with a like. Hook me up with a like. Okay, so here's what it comes down to. With your 808, you want to look for something that saturates the sound. There's a free plugin called Soft Tube Saturation Knob. You can use this, it's free. So we'll start with this, but I might switch it out for a different sound.
Busy.
So what you do is just pull down your 808 fader and just pick whatever style of saturation you like and just turn up the knob.
Busy.
It's gonna make the 808 sound buzzy.
Busy.
So you hear it getting buzzier?
Busy.
Busier.
Busy.
So I'll crank it up pretty high. So the cool part is that the kick is so full, it has that sub frequency, like the 30 to 60. So the 808 doesn't need to be as boomy. And that's why I like to have the balance of the kick that sounds more full with that boom, with the buzzier 808.
Busy.
And we can balance the smooth with the, and I'll show you how to, let's quantize these notes, Alt Q. Here's what I'll do to get the melody out of the way. We're gonna flip the gross beat. Let's go back to default. Let's go to time. And I'm just showing you guys how to, like, you gotta know how to finesse your melodies a little bit. So I'm gonna create like a, it's gonna create whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. It's gonna swell up like that.
Busy.
So it can get out of the way of the transient of the kicks and the 808s. So let's do it this way instead of the other way around, which made it a little more sawtooth ramp style.
Busy.
So it sounds like it's in reverse, even though it is in reverse, but you could use this effect to create a fake reverse effect.
Busy.
Just using a volume control.
Busy.
And that will make the melody get out of the way. It opens up a lot of room. I want to see what it sounds like back the regular way. All right, my bad. Is it echoing at all? Let me triple check the stream. Sometimes it echoes when we come back into FL. As long as it's not echoing, we're good. Chat, let me know, is it echoing? Just need your quick feedback. Hold on. As long as it's not echoing. Oh, no, we're not echoing. Okay, good. Because, again, sometimes I leave. Anyway, so we saw what happened.
Busy.
So the 808 should be distorted. Okay, then I'll show you how to really like finesse the 808s to make it like super. The guitar could be harder. I just didn't have enough time to dig into it. Okay, so now that we have all this stuff, I really think it's ample guitar that's causing that issue. I might, never mind, we're doing too much.
Busy.
Okay, now what was I doing? I forgot what I was doing, y'all. Help a brother out. Adding chorus to the 808. I think that's what I was doing. Oh, 808 slides. So before we get to the mixing, let's add some 808 slides. So instead of thinking of slides as a separate thing, think of it like you're playing a note over top of another note. So I'm just gonna add these little, like I'm just playing the note on top of another note, and they're gonna be really short.
Busy.
So the first note you wanna try out is an octave up or down, but I'm gonna do up in this case. So the octave up, we're gonna play G up one octave. We're not gonna make it a slide note.
Busy.
Should we make it a slide note? Let me think for a second. Let's go to the wrench tool. Let's turn on mono mode. Let's see what this sounds like first before we make it a slide note.
Busy.
Never mind, it doesn't do what I thought it was gonna do. Let's double click, let's make it a slide note, even though I didn't wanna make it a slide note. Because we have to pull it back down. That's why I didn't wanna make this too complicated, but basically we need two slide notes. So one is playing the note, the other note is sliding up to another pitch, and then the other slide note is sliding it back down.
Busy.
But the thing is, it shortens out, so that's why I didn't like that method.
Busy. Busy.
Let's do regular notes. And I'll show you how to slide from the top note back down. So let's do.
Busy. Busy. Busy.
Now, technically, this should be a. I mean, I have so much to show you guys. Let's put it in mono mode. Now, it should pitch bend. I don't know. This seems to have some type of overridden function. We need to figure out what is overriding our pitch slide. It might be because we have cut itself. There we go. So we had to take off the cut itself feature because it was restarting every time. So that's why I wasn't playing that.
Busy.
Let's try it again.
Busy.
So it goes.
Busy.
But it still doesn't give me the sound I want.
Busy.
Let's just do it the old-fashioned way. I'm trying to show you a new way that doesn't really. We're making it hard for no reason. Let's just do it the old-fashioned way. Shout out to Thrill Beats. So here's what we're gonna do is the old-fashioned.
Busy.
We're gonna take this bottom note, make it a regular note. Okay, and then we're gonna go to the top note, make it smaller. Double click on the note and switch it to a slide note. So it's gonna go dun, and then it goes from the bottom note up to this note.
Busy.
That's the typical way. It's probably the easiest way. But the problem is it restarts the 808. So I can't explain what I'm trying to say here. So it's boom, boom, boom. It re-triggers. Whereas I didn't want it to re-trigger. I just wanted the pitch to slide. So in this way re-triggers the sample entirely. So you're gonna hear a new impact. Sometimes you don't want new impacts. So that's why the slide notes, you have to understand where you are with the pitch and in the length of the sample. This 808 specifically has a very short length. So by the time it runs out, it runs out by the time we create the slide note. So that's why I didn't do what I was trying to show you. But if you have a longer 808 that has more sustain to it, you could get away with that.
Busy.
That was for more advanced sound designers who know what the heck I'm talking about. So anyway, take this G note, hit control up.
Busy.
And that's how you get faster slides.
Busy.
You can shorten the note.
Busy.
And then we're just gonna add slide notes in here. So you just double the note, take these bottom notes, hit shift, hit control up twice. I like two octaves up, this is my style. Double click, make it a slide note, double click, make it a slide note. And then just shorten these notes, hit alt and left click.
Busy.
Now you can do it faster than this. Dun, dun. You can do dun, dun, dun. Any kind of ending you want. So let's do this. Again, you just copy these notes, highlight it, hit control, hit shift, hit control up, and double click and make all these slide notes. Just double click, make it a slide note. Now the reason we go so far up in the octave is because we want the pitch to bend really fast. So we're gonna hit control, highlight that, hit alt. Left click.
Busy.
That's gonna give you more of a Pop Smoke pitch bend. Now once you distort it more, you can get really unique tones. So let's pull this down one octave. Let's pull this whole thing down one octave, control down.
Busy.
I don't like the double impact.
Busy.
So what I'm gonna do, since I like just the pitch to bend subtly, that's just my sound, I'm gonna pull this down to a half step.
Busy.
subtle. You can barely tell.
Busy.
Okay, now let's make more of a UK sound out of it. So I'm going to add the slides later because there's a lot of little tedious notes, but let's get into the mixing first so you understand. So the first step is saturation. You could do heavy saturation and then run it through a chorus plugin, like Fruity Chorus is one. You could use the Juno Chorus from Arturia's collection. I like Mode 2, so if you go to Mode 2, it widens out the sound. And we took this from Grime. Okay, so let's put it back on neutral.
Busy.
It needs to be distorted more. So this is why I like, I know I'm all over the place, but this is why I like my specific plugin, Thermionic Culture Vulture. You can use any saturation plugin you like. There's so many. There's Culture Vulture, there's Fruity Blood Overdrive, you have Fruity, what's the other one? Fruity Fast Distort. You have Soft Tubes Saturation Knob. You have T-Rex, what's it called? The Saturator, there's that. You have Fab Filter Saturn. You have Isotope Exciter. There's so many saturators out there. This is just my favorite one because I know how to get the sound that I want.
Busy.
Put it on overdrive to get a dirtier sound. Guitar sounds a little thin.
Busy.
It could use some of that chorus. Need to pull in some of these frequencies. Okay, so let's go to the mid side. Let's pull in the lows because with the chorus plugin, it's widening out the lows. Let's pull the lows back mono.
Busy.
We only want the highs to be spread. So let's keep messing with the saturator. Doesn't have to be that saturated.
Busy. Busy.
Also look into your bias.
Busy.
So this is why we need to balance with the kick and the 808, because this makes the 808 thin. Going to take out some of the highs on the melody. Gonna keep the 808 mono for now.
Busy.
All right, so what I'm gonna do to save time, we're just gonna copy the same 808s because I don't feel like doing all those little tiny 808 slides. You would spend the time to do all those slides.
Busy.
Okay, so now it's time to mix it. Here's where we add our identity to the track. Mixing could take 2 hours. I'm gonna quickly do it. I have to mute my mic because the song's gonna get loud. So I'm gonna mute my mic for a second.
Busy. Thank you.
Still want to add a melody, like a
busy.
Let me see. What kind of melody I want? Find one. We need the one. I have Philharmonic. I forgot I had this.
This might happen.
Check, check. Wait. Hold up. Wait a second. Check, check. Wait. I don't hear anything. I don't even hear myself. Let's just start it. Sorry for the echo. I told you that was going to happen probably. I thought I fixed the echo issue, but apparently not. I think that's what happens when I run it out. So let's start from... All right, should be able to hear me. Can you guys hear me now? Forgive the delay. Our audio program is screwed up. I don't know how to fix it. But it should be fixed. So to triple check, I'm gonna check the stream.
Screwed up, I don't know how to fix it.
It should be fixed. So I couldn't hear the echoes. It's just the problem with this setup. Let's do Mac drill. So I'm gonna not use my outputs because I think what happens is, this is my guess, is that the feedback loop from going out of the computer back into the computer causes like this weird clock issue, and since the clocks don't sync, I think that's what causes the echo. It's my guess, or it could have just been the plugin. Sometimes the plugin freaks out. Anyway, so now we're back to bare minimum, and I guess okay. So let's move into, you guys wanted to do drill and B. I'll let you choose the fusion right now. So we could do drill and B. Let's do a little vote. Which style of drill? We could do UK, we could do Drill MB, we could do, what else did I say? Chicago, which is a whole different type of drill. And then we could do New York style. So I'll let you guys vote. Let's check the audio real quick. Hey, audio's good. My bad for the audio loop, sometimes it happens. You got to vote in the chat. So take a poll. You want UK drill? UK drill, it's not what you guys really think it is. It's very simple. It's just strings, piano, and then the snare is a little bit different. All right. But I'll let you guys vote. You got, what, a minute to vote? I'll let you guys vote. What type of drill do you want to do now? And thank you for hanging in there through the audio glitch. Maybe that's a test to see who's really about it and who's not. The people who are really about it, they don't care about the audio echo. The pansies, they left. You guys want to do UK? Is that a curse word, pansies? UK drill? Well, the whole stream's called drill. I mean, it's clearly going to be drill. You want to do UK drills, what I'm seeing. We have 53 votes. We have 100 and something people here. 130 people here. So half of 130 is 69. Did I do the math right? No, that's not 69. 64. So we need 64 votes to call it. But it looks like you want UK. It's a battle between the UK and New York right now. Let's see who wins. UK or New York. We need 64 votes. We need 7 more votes. You could throw the whole thing. It loopback is not good. I wouldn't recommend it. That's the thing that's causing that feedback, by the way. It's not a good program. If there's alternatives, look for the alternative. Loopback is good. It was good until it wasn't. It's like a serious issue. Anyway, so we have 60. Okay, so you guys want UK drill. So UK drill is about sound effects and it's about rhythms more than it is about instruments. So again, goes back to the, you just need a short hi-hat. Now they do play around with a lot of the hi-hat rhythm, so it's tut. So we're going to be at 144 BPM. That's like the starting point. You could speed it up or slow it down. So it's tut. Not triplets. We're in quarter timing. Let's go to song mode. Now I'm going to shorten this out even further. Fade it out. Now the key really isn't the fade. We don't want a linear fade. I know I'm getting geeky on you guys. But we want more of a concave curvature. So let's go to the envelope mode and let's give this more of a concave shape by changing the tension. That's the type of hi-hat you need. It's a more concave hi-hat, not something that is very full. Okay, let's copy that over. So we'll switch out that rhythm, but that's the core of drill. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. I'm even going to pitch this down a bit just so it's not so ringy. It rings out too long. So let's keep lowering that decay. Even still, I think this hi-hat's too long. Okay, now let's go back to our, again, you're going to get the project files for free. So let's go to the Essential 808s and let's grab that rim. Where's it at? Oh, it's not the right folder. Let's go to this folder, grab our snare. Then, okay, now for this snare, I'm gonna lower the volume and then fade it a little bit more. So it's almost like a percussion. Now here's the difference between UK and American drill. Instead of putting it on the 3 and 7 count, so instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, they put it on the 4 and, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. They put it on the 4 and or the 8. So it's kind of complicated. But use your metronome, 1, 2, 3, 4, and. And then you could do double, like 7, 8, or you could just do 8. So it varies. The original UK drill was on the 4 and. That's why America didn't pick it up right away, because we couldn't understand the rhythm. We weren't used to that bounce. So I'm gonna get rid of the 8. We're just gonna use the 7, so it's the 4 and then the 7. 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7. So that's the count, 4 and 7. Even this hi-hat's a little abrasive. I'm gonna take off some of the high end. So now we need a bass that's like boom. I've studied this stuff. I know this stuff. Stop trying to correct people who you've not studied before. If you go listen to the original, it came from Grime. So let's open up the bass. We need a bass that goes whoom. Now here's where you get into your EDM bag. So let's go to Serum just to see what they have on their presets. Let's go to bass. What was loud? So we want something that swells up, similar to R&B. I know in Omnisphere where we can grab it. Something like this could work. This is a little too reverby. And it sounds like it has a fifth in FM. Yeah, it does sync. But this is more housey. So if you wanted to go to the house route. But you would have to create the swell effect. So this is not a swell effect. Let's give it more attack. You gotta time it. Let's do this. Hold on. It's also adding, we're taking elements from Garage. Mm-hmm. We need to figure out which envelope is modulating the filter. Let's see. Envelope 2. So this is controlling the filter. But we're getting into our sound design bag. Let's add some legato, a little portamento. Okay, so for grime, we want to think chorus, we want to think distorted and wide. So that's the difference between, that was the merger between grime music and then what they call drill. This is the early phases of it. So that's how you get that EDM type bass. But the trick is finding the perfect timing of the attack. So I might just do a little. Okay, and then you could do like the garage style, how they do the dimension widener. So we have a dimension widener. That's what gives it that big sound. So I'm going to copy a little bit from garage. Okay, so that's how you can twist it. We're doing like a fusion. Let's record this. I played it too slow. Let's do that again. So this is gonna be our change up into garage. Then we'll do like a different rhythm. So I wanted to dun 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 dun. So here's where we copy the hi-hats. Dun, dun, 1, 2, 3. Let's go to snap the grid. Let's go to triplets. We need to lock in. So let's hit Control Q. I think we're on triplets. Let's see. Just gotta find the right grid. I can't tell if it's triplets or if it's quarter time. Let's keep going back and forth. Never mind, it's quarter timing. So over time you can control the cutoff. So we're gonna grab that, go to the drop down, let's go to browse parameters, and then we can right click, create an automation clip. So this is where we wanted to get bright. So we're gonna copy this value. This is gonna be our max value. Let's paste, right click and paste. But for the beginning portions, we want it to be lowered so the filter doesn't open up that wide. So this is a little more advanced sound design stuff. So it's gonna be a little more muffled. Now we're not gonna start off, we're not gonna start the beat on this bass. And we're gonna add FL keys to get that, where's FL keys? To get that gritty, this is more of an East Coast America sound. Lower the release, lower the detune. Let's go down 2 octaves. So here's where you come up with your piano melody. Now, most of the kids who made the melodies don't know how to write melodies. So mine's going to be a little more musical. That's just my style. Let's take out the highs. It's coming with a melody order. Then where do we go from? That was way too musical. We're just using half steps. I have to do it at the end because I have to go to Dropbox and load it up. Just gotta wait till the end. Okay, so when you hold the sustain notes, everything looks like one big long note. So we're gonna hit Alt Q to quantize this stuff. Now the problem is in FL, if any notes overlap, it causes an issue. So we're gonna hit Control, left click to highlight, hit Alt L, and then hit Only With Selection, and that will get rid of any overlapping notes. So that's gonna happen per note, especially if you quantize after using a sustain pedal. So just keep that in mind. Now we can convert this to audio in reverse. So let's just see what it sounds like in reverse. Let's consolidate from track start. This may or may not crash the project. Let's try it. All right, it didn't crash. Okay, so we're gonna go here and reverse the audio. I like it, but it doesn't line up. I like the reverse sound. It just isn't lined up the way we want. So let's see what we could do. Let's try one thing, but that is the sound that we're going for. Or what I could do, let's do this. Let's just cut out the very beginning and just duplicate. Hit shift, left click. But I want it to be like dun dun. I don't want it to be like dun dun. We want reverse piano, but I like the forward piano melody. Oh, you know what? Let me try one more thing. I forgot at the very end. Let's see what this is. Hold on. It's hard to think in reverse, but what you could do, if you're dead set on reverse, you could always go to your tools, flip tool, flip it horizontally. Now see how it messes up all the notes? So I don't understand how FL does this. Let's try both. Because sometimes when you hit flip and you preserve the times, it does like this weird quantized thing. But then when you don't do it, sometimes it doesn't, but the notes are on point. So this is what it sounds like in reverse. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna move the notes around in reverse as we're listening to it. So I'm gonna go dun. Gonna take out these double notes. We don't need the bass to hit double. I'm gonna take out the bass for now because I want to hear the melody. Wait. What we could do, to Control L, gets rid of all those overlapping notes. So again, when we reverse it, it's gonna sound like this in reverse. We're using a lot of half steps. A to A sharp or B flat, and then D to D sharp or E flat. So it's those notes right next to each other that create the tension that we need. So here's where I'm gonna change it up. half step. Okay, so now we have that in reverse. Now we're gonna reverse the reverse. So let's consolidate from track start. And I forgot the reverse. Oh, I'm an idiot. I forgot one button. Let's hit reverse. Let's go to piano roll. Let's go to tools, flip. Let's flip it back horizontal. Let's make sure the time lines up. All the notes change. This is so, gotta redo what we just did. Everything is reverse. This is so crazy. I don't know what FL does when it does that, but anyway, let's reverse it. Consolidate from track start. This should fix it. If not, then I'm just too many reverses. It's like Uno. Let's reverse. It's not the order of notes I wanted. Whatever. The melody did not come out the way that I want. We just did all that just to delete it. Don't you hate that feeling? All that effort just to delete it. Let's just do forward melodies. When we hit too many reverses, my brain just gets a little lost, to be straight with you. Especially with that time. When it says preserve time, threw me off big time. Okay, let's add more bounce. So I've been taking forever to get here. I'm gonna use Ramon's, it's called, oops, all right, the audio works. I'm gonna use Ramon's kit. So he does more of like a dance hall type sound. Okay, so let's go to Ramon's kit. Let's use some hand drums. Anything like tight hand wood percussion. You don't want anything too islandy though. I don't want you guys to get too used to that bass. I'm gonna mute it for a second. Let's go for, so he's a bunch of rim sounds. So I'm gonna layer this on it. So here's where we're gonna move a little into the advanced world. This is not really a beginner's part right here. We're gonna layer the rim sounds, but only at certain impacts. So it's not both impacts. It's only on the second one. Then we're gonna keep layering all these rims. Now, if you're going more like Afrobeat slash drill, you can do the dun, 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 dun. So it's up to you what kind of style. So I'm gonna add a little Afrobeat influence in here, but now we're gonna go full percussion. So very lightweight snares. Let's open this up. Also, I want to add more hi-hat movements. Just so it's a little bit more vibrant. Let's make this bigger. So it's very bass and drum focused. We still need, we need like a vocal. Here's what we need right here. Here it is. It's called the Hawaii Shaker. Hawaii Shaker. So we're blending Afrobeat with drill. We're calling it, call it drill Afro drill. Okay, let's go to mode, stretch mode. So it's very percussive. We're gonna have that build up. So we still need to mess with the attack tone of this curvature. Now we need that thing that's either edgy, or again, we're going dance. Let's go to see what his melodies are like. That's a cool melody. Let's drag that in. Whoops. So we're gonna flip this melody. Let's switch up the BPM. This is 96 BPM. We're gonna cut the tail. And we're gonna make this unique as a sample. Hit yes. Then we're going to mess with it. So I'm gonna pitch it up, pitch it down. It's gonna stretch, pull it down. I like the slow down stuff. I'll send this to the mixer. Control L, send it to the mixer. It's a little fast, so I might spread it out a little bit. Let's go to stretch mode. Stretch it to double the length. Add a little reverb. Now the bass is still kind of fighting with this melody because they're in the same octave. So let's try to pull the bass down. Now the bass is way too low. Oh, it switched up. The key switches, so I'm going to cut it. So I'm going to use the top, the bass as like a lead, like the top end of a bass. We're going to use a different bass. Let's go to 3X OSC. Now it's really hard for me to hear that bass, so I got to go up two octaves. But the key to the UK sound is also having a sub layer that's below everything that moves the track. But it's just so hard to hear, so I'm gonna play it up an octave and then pull it down. Figure out the key first. Then we'll get the rhythms right. Okay, remember these are gonna be two octaves lower, so let's go dun, ch, ch, ch. Now I played off the metronome. I probably should have played with the metronome, but let's see. Let's hit Alt Q, Control down twice. The bass that It goes, but it tails off. So I need to figure out. Make these longer. Here's what I'm gonna do. I forgot I'm in like the 18th octave. Here we go. I'm trying to figure out why this is so not in key. I think it's just because it's the waveform itself is a harmonic. So it's playing like a whole different tone. That's why it sounds out of key. So I'm just gonna switch out the bass, not the exact bass I want. Switch it back. A lot of movement. You got the high, you got the shakers, you got the melody. So we need to have something override everything. Here's where gross beat comes into play, and we're gonna have it dip using the volume. So let's right click, create a dip, fade it up, let's go to quarter, and this way we control the groove. Let's pull it back. We can still get the rapidness of the hi-hats, the shakers, but they're not controlling the groove of the track. Let's pull the pitch back up, see if we have a better voicing in the regular octave. So I need like a flute or something to go. I'm trying to figure out what plugin do I want for the flute. Wait, I found a flute somewhere before. I want to say it's Expand 2, but I can't remember. Let's go to Omnisphere. Let's type in flute and sort ratings. I should have. It's not the flute I want. There's a flute sample in here somewhere. It's gotta find it. I think it's in here. Sort ratings. Here it is, the Mellotron. So the pitch in the sample, it goes, it's a little quantized. I would pull, like if I had control over it, I'll pull it a little to the right. pan flute. Where's Nexus? I'm looking for this one sample that sounds like a forest. I think it's called pan flute. Here we go. That's what I'm looking for. This in, dun, 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 dun. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 2. Messed up the second one, but whatever, we got it. It's quantized. 2, 3, 4. Is that a kick? I'm gonna take the Chicago. So I'm gonna record this by hand using the Chicago drill rhythm. Boom, boom, boom at the end. 1, 2, 3, 4. Might change up the bass rhythms, but. Pull up the kick. I just realized I was coming up with speakers. Okay, so the melody needs to change up, but the problem is it's a sample. So the question is, we need to add over it and make it feel like it's still the sample. So it's slowed down and it's ethnic sounds. Let's go to expand to. I think they have an ethnic folder. Let's switch in here. Let's see if they have ethnic. They do. Ethnic used to be a category. Let's see, with the dulcimer, which is like from India, I believe. What other sounds we have? We want the ethnic vibe. We need like a vocal that goes. We need a vocal. Is there a vocal plugin we can use? A lot of these are plucky sounding though. That's the flute I want. That's all I need. I just need something to feel like we're in the desert. That doesn't need to be complicated. Okay, check. There's my mic. Okay, so this has like a vocal thing in it. Let's see what we could do. Let's cut out some of these low mids because it's eating up a lot of space. We could narrow it down, use a band pass. Or we could solo just that high end frequency, that vocal sound. Let's try both. Let's try one. We're gonna cut out the lows, which is that whole like piano sound. Just leave this. Now it feels like a feels lightweight. I like that sound. But let's also try. Let's go to default. Where's our presets? Default. And then we're gonna solo just the bottom end. So if you want more fullness, you could go with this. Either one works. I like this one because it fills out a little more of the low end. Now it's about creepy, making it creepy. Of course, we're gonna slow it down. Anything slowed down feels creepy. Also running it through some pitch modulation. I'll show you how to do it in a second. But if we slow it down that much, we have to pitch it up so that we're not in that deep octave. Let's pull it up one octave, but then run it through Grosby so it pulls it back down an octave, but it slows it down. One thing about gross beat, if you mess with one thing, it'll reset gross beat. Where's our... We need like a sound effect. We need like a flutter sound effect, like a... I know where it's at. It's an Omnisphere. If you go to samples, let's go here. Let's go to sample. Let's pull it up. Let's type in flute. And it should be, where is it at? It's one of these. So we're going to figure out which one sounds the best. It's not this one, but we'll find it. Need something to be like exaggerated. Boom, boom, boom. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, my lights flickered. So here's where we can automate gross beat so it doesn't sound like the same thing. So I'm gonna right click, create automation clip. This is why I said, if you're stuck with the loop, you're kind of like, it's up to the discretion of the loop maker. I don't have control over the music. But you can add stuff and take it away. I wanna make this more musical. Yeah, we go back to the, feels like two different pieces of music. Then I'll slowly bring gross beat back in. Front is back. See how it gets thrown off? So if I move knobs, gross beat gets thrown off. Alright, so the bass timing needs to be matched up with the kick. But even still, the gross beat keeps throwing off the timing once the automation kicks in. So I'm going to turn off gross beat for a second. So your track should bounce without your kicking your snare, in this case. The bass could be like, there could be a little more movement. So I'm gonna see what I can add here. One sec. So I need to be dun 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 dun. So it needs to be dun 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 dun. Double kicks. You can lower the velocity on the one. Or just shorten the note. It's such a low note, it doesn't even have time to. Sounds like a little click, but I'm pulling it up an octave so you can hear it. Let's go back. 3, 4, 1, 2. And these double notes in here. I'm gonna copy that one over because I don't feel like duplicating all that. It's just copy it over, snap the grids, go to bar, hit Command D or Control D. Excuse me, Command B or Control B on computer, on PC. Hit Control down. You can do an 808 with the bass, but I'm not going 808 with this track. Let's unlock our tracks. So next, we need to group our instruments into one track. So I'm gonna find all the instruments. We have the melody. So anything you want to be, I'm gonna put the hi-hat, I'm gonna put the shakers into the instruments. Anything I want to be modulated here, let's route directly to that track. I guess you can put the hi-hats in here. Grab the hi-hats. Right click, route to this track. Turn that flute down. Let's add that in the instruments. Route to this track. Now anything that has its own reverb, I like to turn off the reverb inside the plugin. This has a court, it had a soft plate reverb on it. So I think that's it. Okay, so we're gonna go to the instruments. Now we're gonna add our own processing chain. Let's do Fruity Delay 3. Wet level all the way up, feedback level down, delay time down, turn time modulation up. Let's get rid of the flute, because that's a little heavy. Oh, also I forgot we don't gross beat on. Where's the gross beat? So I'm going to play the flute only when Grossbeat's on. Because it has enough room. So everything's going through Fruity Delay 3 right now to get that time pitch modulation. And then I'm going to add a Fruity, what's it called? C6 sidechain stereo. Now again, the bass could be a different bass. I'm just using a sub bass to keep it extremely simple. Only thing is when the automation kicks back in, it throws off the rhythm. Other than that though, let's find our kick. We're going to right click sidechain to this instrument track. Go to your sidechain, go to the settings, go to processing, right click and select your kick, turn it on. Then we're gonna go back to the front, and then you wanna decide which frequency range you want to bob when the kick hits, so you can control the mids. And this is gonna create the movement in the track. Technically, the bass should be on there too. When you start rerouting things, make sure you go back into the settings and make sure your kick is the input. So I like the mids cut out, but let's try the lows. It also gives us a sound. A little movement. Okay, let's bring in the bass over time because the bass doesn't just start. Also the kick, I think this is the kick. We can bring in the kick somewhere around here. And the goal is just send your instruments to the reverb. So it's pitch modulated. This is gonna give a haunted type sound. There's also a plugin, I forget the name of it. I wanna say Lexicon. I think it's the Lexicon Hall. Wait, Lexicon 224, I think. Here it is. You could do, so the reverb pitches itself up. So these little knobs in the top left, you can't see it, but it says pitch. If you hit that, you could pull this up one octave so that the pitch goes up on the reverb. Let's see if I can exaggerate the sound. Let's put it on the hall. Turn it up. Where's the mount? It goes like, it's hard to hear. The reverb's so soft. But here goes, wow. Here, pitch up. Okay, so that's like a haunted sound. You could use that effect. That's a reverb pitched up effect. I'm not gonna use that one. I'm gonna use pitch modulation. All right, I was just EQing the kick. Open these tracks up. All right, it just needs vocal. It needs some expressive melody. If you wanted to make this edgy, you could do the Let's do silent one. So I'll show you how to get the edgy bass. Not this one. Let's go to menu. Clear it on out. So we're going to do sine wave. And then underneath, we're going to put a sawtooth or pulse wave. Pulse wave gives you more grit. Let's go down an octave. Let's turn the voicing to one. And let's turn the mono legato mode on and add a filter, a low pass filter. So you could go with this sound. If you want a harder approach. Now every beat, I don't like hard beats, like beat battle beats. Its own thing. See if I can find a vocal thing and then we'll move on to the next. What time are we at? We've been streaming for like 3 hours. We've been streaming for 2.5 hours. I need you to smash the like button. We're going to move to the next beat in a second. Because there's nothing to add to that except, what am I doing? What are we doing here? Nothing to add to that except a vocal melody and it would sound like this. I don't know, like UK lingo, but it'd be like, bruv. That I love to single, top right, top for the singles. Came back, rock for the bingos, that break down, but I snap like jingles. Wall got chips like Pringles, pull up on your block, let's play that tingle. Rock for the jingle, blah, da da da, but that's that tingle. Big that's chain, big ass chain, but it. Let me do a Drake verse, because I don't know UK slang. Bound for the way I came up. Visa, the way I play ya. 16 balls on the cane for the danger. I speak up with a coley lit, but it lit like AC danger. AC gray, AC taste, I got Macy day. Little top, but that look fitted in my AC gray. In my true. It just doesn't matter, but I don't want it. Pretty damn pretty. Nah, I'll start rapping. Let me stop rapping. This last beat, we gotta move faster though, because that took a long time. Save this. All right, live stream. It's called a Drilla. I got a name for it. Drilluminati. Genius. This one's going to be called Drilluminati. You heard it here first. Where is it at? So we're going to make this sound extra sci-fi. So we're going to start with the music first and then add all the rhythm stuff. Let's just get abstract here. We're going to go to... We need to find some type of padsy sound. Omnisphere is like the easy go-to. Let's just go to Omnisphere. Then I'll show you guys how to pull up and make some crazy melodies. So this one will focus specifically on the melody because I think you guys get the drum concept by now, hopefully. I think I have some presets in here. User and... Let's use some presets that I made for you guys a while back. I should add these to the Discord. That's kind of Kanye-esque. It's a bell for you. I'm gonna play musical stuff. Let's see if we can combine music with drill. This is a Kanye patch. This definitely is not going to translate into drill unless we sample it some type of way. This is just a bop. Let me play this for a second. Oops. Whatever, I played the wrong thing again. All right, let's see. We need one sound. We need a padsy sound. So let's do Pop Smoke. Let's do, what would Pop Smoke play? Like G minor. Or he would play B minor. Let's do B minor. Let's do G major. Then F major 7. And then A minor something. Something like that. So let's play B minor again. Forgot what I just played. B minor, G major. Da, da, da. Super 80s. Can we drill that out? Is that possible? The rhythm is not drilled though, but the chords could be. So I made these really. Again, I forgot the chord press. B. Maybe Kanye / Pop Smoke RP. Let's do a Kanye / Pop Smoke track. How would that sound? Oh, here's a cool one. So we have B minor. We're gonna get Drilluminati up in here. It's about to get so crazy. So, I'm gonna treat this like a drum. So here, we're gonna get weird on this part. Let's do this. Okay. That's not fast enough. Okay, so that's gonna be the background rhythm. We're gonna twist that. Think Kanye / Pop Smoke. Let's build on top of this. But when I came out, stranger. My computer. Oh, I forgot. These, if you press one note, it plays random notes. Just gotta find the root note, which is B. That one's a little random. Here we go. It's about to get. Black Panther. Wait. Okay. Sorry if it sounds super loud, my bad. Now we're gonna do the rhythm. Outside, cause niggas know we outside. Let's do something like that. So we're gonna use the drill pattern, which is tap 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 tap, but only do it at the end. Yeah, let me make sure it lines up. So instead of the tap 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 tap, we're leaving out four of those notes. Let's quantize these notes. Bass is a little sluggish, I have to figure out why. Let's find a kick. Quantize the bass wrong at the end. Oh, I know why. It's because these aren't overlapped. Forgot I quantized. Then I'll do the vocal melody placeholder. Bass is a little bright, so we're gonna lower what's called the envelope, mod envelope. That kick is so loud, let's pull it back. Let's record. One, two, three, four. I messed up the end, but whatever. Just realize these are guitar hits, a little delayed. So what I'll do is grab these, hit Alt Left. It must be modulated by something else. Figure out what to modulate it real quick. Has to be LFO. Okay, so this is LFO. Okay, so that's just moving like that. That makes sense. A little early. This rhythm is thrown off the kick because it's an LFO is controlling it, so that's why it's not perfectly locked to the grid. I'll come back to that. For now, I'm just gonna delay the kick. So again, we're thinking Kanye / Pop Smoke. Think pop music. Thank you. dun. So I'm doing like a Zaytoven type of blues, going outside the key. Coming back down. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's hard with the rhythm being off though. I'm gonna listen to the metronome. You can always fix it in the MIDI. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a little too quantized. Too quantized sounding. Alt Q. 3, 4. See how the melody got all twisted. Just gonna keep that one because it's quantized. Sounds computerized. So that's gonna be the creepy element. This bass never came back to its sound. Let's pull it back. Kick is way too loud. Let's pull it back. Thinking harmonic, like how do we add harmonics to it? Thinking harmonically right now, frequency wise, we need higher frequencies. And, good, yeah. Could do a vocal. Then let's do a Kanye verse. Scalar or key ring? It won't let go of the key. Why is it doing that? Alright, this thing's broken. Let's do this again. Thing broke on me. Use the vocals as an instrument. F sharp minor. Here we go. We need reverb. Set that up. Checking in out. When you do that, tell me at your ear, but where's that minor? Lot of cheese, lot of Same snare. I'm gonna use a different snare. Let's use our. Trying to think where I keep my snares out. Put an alternate producer bundle. Because what's throwing off the rhythm is this. So I'm going to save this project, convert this to audio so we can get this lined up better to the grid. So right now it's not matching the groove. All right, so let's do this. Let me know if it echoes. Sometimes it echoes. Is it echoing? Let's check. Is it echoing? Check. Okay, it's not echoing. Sometimes it echoes when I render, so I had to triple check. Always triple check. Okay, so this should be, I don't see any. Oh, here we go. So what I wanna do, this is very like quiet audio. So we're gonna click here, gonna normalize, pull the volume down, and you can visually see how it's not on the grid. So let's go to snap to grid, half beat, and then let's start cutting this and moving the transients around, because right here, it's not on the grid. You can visually see it's not lined up right. So we're going to use the slip tool, hit alt and left click, drag the stuff around. And this one we need to drag it and then hit alt, drag it, and then get rid of the rest by taking it off stretch mode and hitting alt to get rid of it. It should fix it this way. actually what might be better. We might just, it might be better if we loop it, because it has, yeah, let's just loop it. All right, send this to here. Why did, I don't know why it became super quiet, so let's turn it back up. We in the ghosts. We in the ghosts in a new lane. Iceberg that is in a new chain. BVS diamonds in a new chain. We in the ghosts. We in the ghosts finna hit a stain. Iceberg that is in a new chain. Ice BBs in a new stain. We in the ghosts. Does that have some more Kanye vibes to it? We need more hi-hat movements, so I'm gonna create a secondary track where it's tap 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 tap, but we're gonna pitch it down, hitting shift down. Let's add that in. We have to balance the bass with the kick, so we're not fully mixing this track. Too much hi-hat, I feel like, eats up too much space. We need that thing, that vocoder thing that Kanye uses. But I don't have it on his computer. He has a vocoder that like spreads his vocal into four things. I don't think I have an alternative. What could we do? We could do, I don't think I have the event tied, I don't think. Yeah, I don't have it, darn. Let me think of a pitch editor. I think Guitar Rig has one. We be in a ghost. But it's not the exact thing, but it's a harmonizer from Entourage that Kanye would use on this. I don't have the exact thing. So I think under, is it Rezo chord? Check, check. Why do I sound louder? Okay, guitar rig is amping me up clearly. All right, there we go. So you see how I can talk into this, but it's only playing one chord. Let's switch it to a minor. Let's do, what key are we in? I forgot. We're in F sharp minor. Can you resist? Can you resist? Can you resist? This is not the Entourage sound that I was going for, but I'm just showing you. Can you resist? Wait for it. Let's wait. So that's what Kanye would add to it, in my opinion. But not that plucking though. Check, 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 check. And it's not the building on a monsoon. I've been drinking by the time. Waiting for another location just to drop on you. Maybe black would be better than Kanye on this one.
Hit it lit. I didn't hit it lit. Go for my song. Driven a bit of a night school. Back in high school. I know.
Yeah, I feel like black would just sound better.
I hit a lick. I didn't hit a lick in a mind song. NBA driving, but it's all news. I'ma see it back when I go to school. And that's it.
Wait, nah, I lost the melody I had in my head.
Illuminati in a mind song. I stink it when it all cool. If I use it, it gets you all cool. Illuminati.
Here's the problem with these beats. It's so non-musical that you can't even take it anywhere musical. And that's what frustrates me, because I like to take stuff musical into a musical space. Why do I sound louder? I know I'm not tripping. Hold on. Check, check, check. Something just sounds louder.
Illuminati in a mind song. I stink it when it all cold. If I get you all cool.
Forgot that melody we did for Pop Smoke. I like the Pop Smoke one the best. So from here you would stack 808s, but mixing that is gonna drive me insane. Mixing the 808 with the bass. I guess I could start to show you. It's basically sidechain compression, but frequency-based sidechain compression. Let's find an 808. Where's our 808s?
We in the ghost in a new lane. Iceberg that is in a new chain. BVS diamonds in a new chain. We in the ghost. We in the ghost finna hit a stain. Iceberg let us in a new chain. Ice BBs in the new same. We in the ghost. Stars in the ceiling in the new lane.
Looking for an 808. Here it is. Found it. Now I'm gonna mute the bass for now, cause hearing two basses.
We in the ghost in a new lane. Iceberg that is in a new chain. We in the ghost. We in the ghost in a new lane. Iceberg that is in a new chain. BVS diamonds in a new chain. We in the ghost. We in the ghost finna hit a stain. Iceberg let us in a new chain. Ice BVs in the new same. We in the ghost. Stars in the ceiling.
I'm doing more like an East Coast bass.
We in the ghost. We in the ghost in a new lane. Iceberg that is in a new chain. BVS diamonds in a new chain.
I forgot how I do the kick. technically they should be lining up the kick. Some of those didn't line up with the kick already. So we're gonna unlock the bass. Where's it at? So we're gonna put a C6. I don't know why I sound louder. Maybe because I'm not. I don't know what I did, but I sound louder for some reason. What was I gonna say? Let's open up a C6 sidechain stereo over the bass, and then we're gonna grab our 808, right click, sidechain to that track, go to your settings, go to your processing tab, right click, select your 808, turn it on, go back to your front page, and then we want to turn it on the low band. There has to be something feeding back. I sound louder. I know I'm not going crazy. Check. Whatever. So every time the 808 hits, it's gonna duck the bass. We need to give it an envelope. But we have a kick, we have an 808, and we have a sub bass, so this is where it gets complicated. So the kick needs to sidechain the 808. This is why I said I didn't want to do it this way. But let's just do Fruity Limiter, because I don't feel like doing all this. Go to your kick, find your 808, right click, sidechain to that track. Go back to your limiter. Go to compressor mode, lower your threshold down. Turn your ratio up as high as you want. I'll just put it all the way up. We want the release tail to be quick though, so we don't want it to pull on too long. Oh, I forgot to set the sidechain. Here we go. Right click. Losing a lot of the bass, so this is where you gotta find where the 808. So I'm just gonna take off the 808. Because the mix these together would take a lot of time. So don't forget you can slow down the BPM. Let's go down here. Let's put this on stretch mode. I'm definitely hearing myself twice. There's no way. Check. So anyway, go to tools, maybe because I'm so close to the mic. Go to tools, macro, switch all audio clips to real time, stretch it, okay? And then pull down the BPM. Now it's gonna slow down your melody. Might be too slow. But at least the kick is time to ride out. I'm gonna route the kick to the sub bass instead.
Balls in the ceiling in the new lane. Iceberg, better see the new chain. BBB's diamonds in the Mosaic. We in the ghost.
Since the beat is repetitive, because I didn't change it up, because that snare. So, I mean, at this point, I don't know, it still needs a musical thing to it. It needs a good melody to it. Now I just want to make a beat. I just want to end this off with a beat, even though it's not going to be drill. 100 people in here, I guess I will. We've been at 3 hour mark, so next, I'm going to make a beat, just any. Gotta make sure it's not looping back. Hold on a sec. Check. Okay, so we got that. All right, so now we're just gonna make a beat. I know the thing says drill, but we've been on so long that we kind of beat drill to death. I need something a little more exciting. Let's do musical. No, let's call it melodic. Let's call it melodic punk. Shout out to Young Thug and his new album. Let's open it up. So this beat, I'm gonna make it fully on my speakers. So I'm not gonna talk as much, that way I can make this beat on my speakers. And I can actually hear what the heck is going on. Check. Cool, so if I leave the mic on, it'll feedback. So first we need a melody or an instrument. As I'm starting to produce more, I start to realize how much I actually like real instruments as opposed to synths and plugins. There's just real instruments just have a lot more depth that you really can't get with plugins like that. So let's see, let's go to good old Omnisphere. Good old So now we're just making a beat, and I'm going to mute my mic and just finish this off with a beat. All right, so I was just playing it over the speakers just to get my beats sound better when I make them over the speakers. Also, I didn't want to hear feedback. Still needs some kind of, I don't think the kick is gonna fit with this type of track. So what I'm gonna do, I want to add like another melodic thing in here. Sticking with Omnisphere just because I really don't feel like finishing this beat though. Just needs drums. Just like finding the right kick sometimes can be a bother. So let's go to EDM. Where is it at? So now we're just gonna add that extra synth in here. I'm tucking everything in the instruments track so I can get sidechain. That's my voice. Wait, hold up. Is that wrong? The track just needs better hi-hats and a better kick pattern. And maybe another synth, maybe not. I'm tired. How many people are even in here? I'm tired, y'all. I gotta get off. I can't even think of a melody. I'm gonna wrap this live up because I'm tired. Thank you. Peace. I'm tired. Join us in our Discord. You're gonna get all these project files for free. I'm gonna load them up soon. Peace.